Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. This is the third video in the AVR series using the Explained Mini Board, and today we will see how to use the UART. The UART peripheral is a big topic to cover, so we will cover it in multiple videos. This video will cover the initialization of the UART, the board rate configuration, and finally we will send the data using the UART. The reception of the data will be covered in the next video, and later we will develop a more robust library to send and receive data via the UART, just like the Arduino have. Let's check the ATtiny817 datasheet. Here you can see the USART features. It supports the full duplex operation, and the one-wire mode and RS485 mode in the half-duplex operation. We can use asynchronous or synchronous operations. It supports up to 9 data bits with 1 or 2 stop bits. The baud rate generator can generate any baud rate without the need for an external oscillator. It has the built-in error detectors, and the separate interrupts for transmit and receive. It supports other modes as well, but we will cover them later in the series. We will see the rest of the description later in the video, when we will cover the specific register. Let's check the register description. We have the receiver data registers in the beginning, we will cover these in the next video. The transmit data register is used to store the data that needs to be sent via the UART. The low byte register holds the first 8 bits of the data. If the data length is 9 bits, we can use the high byte register to store the 9th bit of the data. The status register can be used to check various flags, like receive complete, transmit complete, data register empty flags, etc. We will cover this later in the video. The control A register is used to enable or disable various interrupts. We are not going to use the interrupt to transmit the data, so let's skip this. This is the register we are going to start with, the control B register. Before we go into the details here, let's create a new project in the Microchip Studio. I am using a virtual machine on Mac, so things might be a little different from how they would appear on Windows. Give some name to the project, and click OK. I am using the ATtiny817. Here is the code from the previous project, and I will use the same clock initialization that I used in the previous projects. Initialize the clock in the main function. Now we will write a separate function to initialize the UART. Here we will start with the control B register. The 6th and 7th bits of this register enables the transmitter and receiver for the UART. I will leave the rest of the bits to their default states, so start of frame detection is disabled, open drain is disabled, which sets the receiver in the normal operation mode, and also the multiprocessor communication is disabled. So basically we are just going to set the 6th and 7th bits of this register. The next register is Control C. The 7th and 6th bits of this register control the communication mode. We will leave this to asynchronous mode. The 5th and 4th bits control the parity mode. We will disable the parity here. The 3rd bit controls the stop bit mode. We will use one stop bit. The first 3 bits control the character size, basically the data length. We will set it to 8 data bits. Basically we will use the standard 8 data bits with one stop bit, and no parity. So we need to set the control C register as 03 hex. Next we have the baud register. It's a 16-bit register, and the value stored in this register generates the baud rate at a specific frequency. The baud rate calculation is shown in the UART description above. As you can see here, the formula to calculate the baud register value includes the peripheral clock, the S value, and the desired baud frequency. The S value for the synchronous normal mode is 16, and let's say I want the baud rate of 11,5200. We still need the peripheral clock to complete this formula. Let's check the clock controller. In the main code, we have defined the CPU clock at 5 MHz. This is because the oscillator of 20 MHz is being used along with the prescaler of 4. You can see in the clock controller, after the main clock prescaler, the CPU clock and the peripheral clock, both are at the same frequency. So the peripheral clock should also be the same, 5 MHz in our project. Here we got the value for the baud register, 173.6. We can't use the decimal value, so I will just use the value 174. The rest of the registers are not needed for today's tutorial. Let's go back to the status register. Here we are interested in the transmit complete interrupt flag. This bit is set when the entire data is transmitted, and there is no data in the transmit data register. This bit is cleared by writing a 1 to the bit. Note that even these bits are interrupt flags, but they are set irrespective of whether you have enabled the interrupt or not. The interrupt is triggered when the respective bit is set in the status register, and the respective interrupt is enabled in the control register A. Since we haven't enabled the TX interrupt in this register, the interrupt will not generate when the data has been transmitted. Only the status register bit will be set, and we can use it to monitor if the data has been transmitted or not. We will clear the TX interrupt flag during the initialization. That is it for the UART initialization. Now we will configure the pins. The explained mini board supports the virtual COM port, which means we don't need external hardware to communicate to the computer. Simply connect the USB cable, and we can communicate to the computer using the UART. Here is the schematics of the board. You can see the pins PB2 and PB3 are the USART TX and RX pins respectively. If you are using an external hardware to connect to the computer, the connection will be as shown here. Connect the TX pin of the MCU to the RX pin of the module, and vice versa. To configure the pins for the USART, we need to set the TX pin as the output, and the RX pin as the input. We will set the port bidirection register as 4 hex, and this will set the pin PB2 as the output, and the rest of the pins as input. Now let's write a new function to send a byte data via the UART. Since we are only using 8 data bits for the UART, we will load the data into the transmit data low register. Now we will wait for the TX complete interrupt flag to set in the status register. This bit will be set when the data has been shifted out, and the data register is empty. Now clear the bit by writing a 1 into it. This completes the transfer of a byte data to the UART. Similarly, we will write another function to send the entire string. Here we will call the byte transfer function as long as the string is valid. That's all the functions we need for today's tutorial. Let's initialize the UART in the main function. This is the data that I am going to send to the terminal on the computer. In the while loop, we will send the string we just defined, every 1 second. As I mentioned earlier, the explained mini supports the virtual COM port, so there is no need for an external hardware for the UART. You can simply connect the USB cable used for the programming, also for the UART communication. Let's build the code now. This is a little different output from what you will see in Windows. Anyway, the code builds fine, so let's flash it to the board. The code flashed successfully, so let's see if we are receiving the data on the computer. Let's check the device manager. Here you can see the COM port 4 is connected, and this is the port used by the board. Actually, you will see it differently on a Windows PC, but this is how it is on a virtual machine. I am going to use the real term for the serial communication on the computer. The port 4 is already opened. Let's change the baud rate to 115200. You can see we are receiving the data every second. Let me modify the string transmitted by the MCU. Now let's build and flash the code again. Here you can see the modified string is being received on the monitor. So the UART transmission is working fine. I hope you understood the process of configuring the UART and transmitting the data via the UART. This is it for this video. In the next video, we will cover how to receive the data from the UART and store it in a buffer. The link to download the code is in the description below. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.